Welcome to Grinnell, Iowa, home of Grinnell Mutual. Grinnell has been protecting farms and homes and businesses across the USA for more than 100 years. And today we'll be looking at how Contego can protect some of the highly flammable materials used by their clients. We'll start with HDPE wall panels, widely used but highly flammable. HDPE is short for high density polyethylene. Technicians from Grinnell start with a small fuel load in a room without Contego's protective fire barrier latex. Well, in less than a minute, the walls are catching, and 30 seconds later, the wall panels are now the fuel. As the HDPE breaks down, the supply of toxic fuel increases, and highly combustible fumes start to accumulate in the ceiling cavity. In less than two short minutes, the fire has approached flashover conditions, and a few seconds later, the fire is obviously out of control. Now imagine if this were a 250,000 square foot warehouse, or a livestock containment facility, or tragically, modular classrooms. There's simply no way to respond to a fire like this. Watch as liquefied fuel is running down the entire back wall. Grinnell insists on finding a solution to save lives and property, so they've come to Contego. Now let's see what happens when we add two coats of Contego's passive fire barrier latex. We'll start with the same small fuel load. But note how Contego immediately forms a protective char barrier that keeps the fire from ever getting to the HDPE wall panels. You know, fire doubles every 60 seconds, but with no fuel, the fire simply dies out. After 4 minutes, the fuel is consumed, the fire goes out, and the structure is saved. Spray-on polyurethane foam is an incredible form of insulation, but Grinnell knows all too well just how flammable it can be. In this test, Grinnell is evaluating a new type of fire-resistant foam being manufactured by one of the biggest names in the industry. But as you can see, using the same small fuel load, ignition happens within 15 seconds, and in less than a minute, it looks like the walls and overhead are about to flash over, but flashover never happens. At 2 minutes and 30 seconds into the test, the fire dies out without any help from the firemen standing by. Now, if you've ever seen polyurethane foam burn, that's impressive. Grinnell knows from experience that structural fires rarely have such a small fuel load. So Grinnell's fire technicians decided to build a 40-pound crib of combustibles, wood, plastic, scraps, all doused in gasoline. Now, this is going to be an entirely different outcome. As you can see, in less than 30 seconds, the corner walls are fully involved. Heavy, dark, and highly toxic smoke is rolling out of the test chamber, and the stage is set for an almost explosive flashover. Now, we decided to let this next segment run in real time, without cuts or edits, to show just how quickly a fire on polyurethane foam goes out of control. The heat is so intense that even the plywood deck of the test chamber flashes over. Again, imagine if this were a large warehouse or commercial structure. The fire grows so exponentially that nothing could be done. So I guess it's back to the drawing board on any claims of being fire resistant. Unless, of course, the foam is protected with Contego. Now we'll run the same sequence beginning with the same small fuel load. However, note how thinly the Contego coating is applied. You can see big gaps running up and down the walls, and you can almost see through the Contego coating to the foam underneath. But no problem, the Contego coating will swell up to close those gaps. The walls are scorched, but the fire can't get to the fuel that it needs, so it simply dies out. Now it's time to toss in the same heavy fuel load that almost instantly sent the unprotected foam into an uncontrollable flashover. Now this is interesting to watch. The hotter the fire, and the more instant it is, the more Contego protects. Even with all those gaps, thin spots, and defects that you saw, these walls will never catch fire, and the only smoke you're seeing is from the 40-pound crib of combustibles and the gasoline. Part of the reason is the nitrogen output that happens when Contego activates. It suppresses the fire, which, as always, simply dies out, and the structure is saved. Check out Grinnell's press release on this site for more details. Remember, fire is the problem, but Contego is the solution. Thanks for taking time to watch, and visit us on the web at www.contegofirebarrier.com.